What's up? Welcome to episode 55 of Let's Build Minecraft. So I was sitting here for a little bit thinking about what I wanted to do today because I wanted to record, but lately I've just been like short on ideas. Like I have these ideas for civilizations, different towns. Like I know that I want to do like an imperial city that's like castle and densely populated, like very stark contrast to this where it's very spread out. And then I have other ideas for other towns I'm not gonna get into right now because, you know, I'm still expanding on them. But then I remembered one of the things that I kind of wanted to do when I first started this series that I kind of lost sight of, and that was building everything with a story so that everything was connected. And that's how we came to this town, actually. If you've been with me for a while, you know that we have a town that we started in, and it's not that great. It's kind of to get my feet wet with YouTubing and whatnot. If we ever head back, there's going to have to be a lot of revisions to the actual building aspect to it. But at some point, I built this barn, and it housed wheat or hay bales for food because they didn't really have much. It was like a fishing town. And then I thought, well, where the heck are they getting all this hay? Let me turn up the render. Actually, it's up to 8. I guess that's how I like it. Just the fog's pretty dense. Let's turn up just a little bit more. Just like that. Anyways, I was like, where are they getting all this hay from? So this is where this town came from. And this is my farming village. Hello, little leg spike. So for those of you that are new, if we come over here, we have rotten flesh and lots of wheat fields. Be right back. I'm getting like these weird leg spikes. I think I've said this in the past, but I don't remember. I'm going to say it again. If you ever get these weird leg spikes, and I don't know why it's happening to me, but I'll be getting like 100 FPS or whatever, and then bam, it'll like just drop dramatically for just a second. And that's happened to me. And then go into your task manager, and if there's two Javas open, delete the one or end the task, the process of the one that's using up the least amount. I don't know why my game's making two Java processes, but that's what's causing the issue. Anyways, back to what I was talking about. So this place kind of came to be because of a story, but then we kind of stopped doing that. Our jungle town that we started, it doesn't really have a story. It doesn't relate to this town at all. As far as I know, these two towns don't even know that they each other exist. But I kind of want to get back into telling a story with my builds, and that's going to do a few things for me. One, it's going to keep everything interesting. By the way, I did this off camera right here. Just a little wheat field to make this an interest spot, which we built last episode. And I added this little wooden wall, different from anything that I've done anywhere else in this town, because I realized that you need unique things around the town, and this area wasn't offering anything. Or wasn't offering enough unique details, I didn't think. Anyways, the other thing that this storytelling, I forgot what I said for the first thing. Did I say a first thing? The first thing that it's going to do is make it more interesting. It'll give us a direction, and it will help me know what to build. So I'm sitting here thinking, gee, what the heck am I going to build? I could build these houses and finish out this town. I could finish out the backside of the Hunter's Guild over there, but I don't think any of you want to watch a full episode on just that. And I don't want to do a full episode on just that, because that's nothing new. That's just finishing stuff that we've already started and really not working on any, no one wants to watch it. Well, I was thinking, I'm gonna start bringing this into our story into this series. And the first thing that I realized is when I built or started this series, I thought that there's probably gonna be a civilization that is perhaps a source of conflict for other towns. Now, there's proof of that in this town. This town is clearly peaceful. It's a farming town. There, you know, no farmers are like suited up with an army. it's not an uncommon theme to see, like, in, like, medieval stories have, like the farmers having a rebellion with pitchforks and whatnot. And we do have a guard barrack right here. So this is lightly fortified. There's a gate here to keep something out. There's barracks here. But what is it for? It's so cool. Yeah, it's a cool building. I like this building, but what the heck is it for? This is more than just a building to me. This is a story, and I forgot that. Well, I realized another thing. If you look this way, now I have the fog all the way up, so you can't really see much. If you look this direction, it's open water, and we have a lighthouse, and you can see that way. If you look this way, it's plains. You can see all the way down there. This way, trees, but we have towers, kind of, to see out there. But what about this way? There's a mountain. How vulnerable are you if whatever enemy came from up here, and then they just stormed down the hill and everyone would be dead and no one would know what happened until it happened? See, just islands. No, not at all. Just mountain up here. So, with that being said, there needs to be some sort of defense, something up here. And the thing that makes the most sense is a watchtower. And we could even do a series of watchtowers. Let me turn down this fog. How do you do that? Other? No. Details? Fog start. Let's turn it all the way up. Let's turn our render distance up. So we have, sorry for the FPS hit while everything's loading in. So we have, you know, a pretty clear view this direction. There's a mountain this direction. If we have, think of Lord of the Rings, where they have, you know, those, like, towers that, like, signal each other. Like, they light the towers, and the next tower in line will light up. The next one will light its flame. So what if we had a tower right here, right where I'm standing? And it's kind of on a little peak right here. It's a good spot. It sticks out the furthest. You know, it's either here or there, but I feel like this is a better spot because this is the direction. You can see more this way and this way than if you were way over there, I think. Maybe not. I don't know. I like this area. So we're going to build a watchtower over here, and we could even build one over there, I think. I wonder if an Enderman put this here. So anyways, I'm going to go to sleep, and then what I'm going to do is build a path winding up here to where our watchtower is going to be to prevent an imminent threat. It's a little bit foreshadowing there. Not gonna spoil anything. Just interesting things to keep in mind. Pathway more or less done. I might go back and touch up some things so I can make it more apparent from down here that it's a pathway, because you can see that something's going on up there, but it's all pretty gray. I may add in some wood, some torches. I added this little post here that I'll probably, you know, elaborate more on that. The only thing I'm really going to say about this is for any of those of you who have been hiking, this will be a no-brainer to you. Don't make your paths just a straight walkway up. Don't have it just go like up, all the way up to there. Make it wind real like pathways uphill. They wind, they change in direction, and they actually aren't that steep. Like I said, those of you that have been hiking will know that. And this pretty much gets that done. Like right here, I don't know, I could introduce some grass maybe. I really want something that can make it stand out from standing over there. Why is it always gotta be going to nighttime when I'm trying to talk? Quick intermission while I'm cutting down trees for our watchtower here. I want to say hello and thank you to all my new subscribers. Lately, we have been seeing subscriber growth more or less every day for a few weeks now, which I think is a pretty big milestone for a YouTube channel to go from getting you getting subscribers and new viewers just when you put out a new video, like a detail tutorial video or something like that, compared to just getting video or getting you subscribers every day, just building off of your past videos and whatnot. So to me, that's a pretty big accomplishment. So hello to all of you, and thank you. I do appreciate it. Okay, I've got some cobblestone in the furnaces because there's going to be a lot of stone involved in this. And it doesn't really matter where we put this. All that we need is that it needs to be visible from this-ish area. So I don't want to put way back here. Preferably something like right there. Let's actually move it up just a tiny bit. Let's just go right here, and we're going to make it 5 wide. So right there, and right here, and right here. And I'm just going to bring these babies all the way up. I'm not even counting. I'm just going to bring them up. Come on, let's go. So I was thinking about while I was like running up here, we obviously just made that path, but I think that things like roads are one of the most overlooked and important details when you're not when you're building just like a single house. When you're looking at the overall picture, I can build these stupid little houses all day long, but if I don't make these roads, what made me think of it was I could spend 15 minutes making one of these houses, and that town wouldn't necessarily feel much more complete. But this area right here feels interesting, exciting. Who knows where this path's going to go? It feels more or less complete. I could do more stuff with it, obviously, but it feels more or less complete. It took me like 4 minutes. It's just like low effort things that people always overlook. Now, this is going to be like a mixture of stone. I don't know how exactly I want to do this. I'm looking at it and just getting ideas. So things are going through my head. I guess I should explain some of this. I want it to be fairly flat. So recently in a build study, we've kind of discovered the importance of walls like that as opposed to having these pillars stuck out one or in one like that. Obviously, that increases the diameter of the circle itself quite a bit. And then you get something more or less that size. Now, that's 5 or 7 by 7 between the things. But you can see that top layer looks quite a bit bigger than this middle layer. It's not necessarily what I'm looking for. But I do want to emulate a sense of change in width at some point. Now, this isn't going to stay all cobblestone. It's more of a placeholder right now. But I've also learned other ways to do exactly what I just said or explain that I'm wanting to do. And that's going to be removing these. All right. First thing that I want to do, let's get, I wish I had ladders. I can make ladders. Let's make ladders. And I'm going to want to, ladders are all stick. It's just fences that they changed. I'm going to fill in this entire thing with, what can I throw out? I'll just throw those out for now. With cobblestone. And I'm going to come back and revisit it. I'm just going to put these here for now so that I have a reliable way to get up and down. And let's fill this in. Let's just do it on one side for now. Because when you're working with something like this, there's no real need to do all the sides. It's just kind of the sides on one side. I don't know why I put the ladder on this side, because now this is where I'm wanting to experiment. So now I have to tear down the ladder because I'm an idiot. And that's not going to take long because I believe this is an efficiency 5 axe. So, yeah, if I were to fill in that backside and not like what I'm about to do, then I'd have to tear it down. But let's actually go up on here because this isn't going to get torn down. We can actually remove a layer or this wooden layer here like this. How far up is that? Let's remove this one as well. I know I'm not speaking very clearly right now. I apologize. And it's more or less what I want to do. I need a way to bridge these. I'm out of cobblestone, really. Let's take this. Let's take a little bit more. I'm probably going to have to go down and grab some. I need to bridge this spot where there's pillar here and the spots where there's not. I have a few ideas. So one way that we've recently learned in our build studies to create a sense of dimension, you know, going in and out, is with these little like faux roofs. I don't know what you would call them. They're not really a roof. Let's put in a door, and I'm not going to put it in the middle. Well, I could put it in the middle. I'll put it in the middle. I kind of wanted to resist the symmetry, but for now, I'll keep it in the middle. So we could do something like this. I want to do... I'm thinking about the possibility of a window. So if we did something like that... We could do window here. If we do that, then that means that the floor is going to be really low, though. Right? So let's not, because I'm thinking about the inside. You could do some sort of like a peephole like that, which makes sense because this is a fortified structure. So let's actually... do something like that. That I don't mind necessarily. And then I'm trying to think of how we're going to bridge this. We could do something like this. It's not terrible, but I'm thinking that I'd rather have it be the same structure as that, just like that. All right, so I'm gonna carry that all the way around and then see how we like it. I've worked out more or less all of the bottom half of this. As you can see, I really like this building. There's some little details that you can really fit in when you're doing like a 5x5 build like this. Like this window is a full block, but it's not on a full block. It's two half blocks. I have this, and this is just my way up for now, but I have this little storage for hay here. It's just a theme for the town, kind of. I realized when looking from down here that this looked kind of boring, so I added a furnace area right here. And then I added another peephole for archers using stairs. So now I'm going to go back up, and we're gonna finish it up, and we're gonna give it a touch to make it known that it belongs to this area. All right, once again, we're gonna carry on with the theme of this little thing, where that little half window and the roof line kind of goes into the window. Not sure how much, how much sense it makes, but it's a consistency now, which is good. Can I get up here? Thank you. I'm going to actually tear you down right away. Okay, so now we're going to just do this with the roof line. And this might actually get changed. Yeah, this top row right here. I'm going to make this roof hay because that's the theme of this area. That's how you know that everything's built in this area. Even the Farmer's Guild has a hay roof on part of it. Just part of it. So we're going to finish this up. I wonder if I can get chicken from this. Nope. Finish up this roof line, and then we're going to knock this little wall down one. Just like that. I probably should do this first while I can reach them. All right, now this is going to be hay. I feel like I want to do this differently than before. And I have an idea, but I'm not sure how it's going to work out. Anyways, we can do it together. Not sure how much time we've been running. Sorry, I realize that my commentary is a little stale when I'm building. I'm trying to work it in, though. So let's do... Ooh. Let's actually put this back. Yeah. It occurred to me, I was doing... You know, I've been doing my build studies on camera, but I do them off camera, too. I've noticed that some people don't necessarily have to have the same material all the way up through their roof. They switch it up, and it can look real nice. That's what we're going to do right now. So let's get some dirt on the bar. And it's getting dark, but honestly, I don't really care since we're up here. As long as it's not too dark. I guess I can put down a torch. No, I can't. I don't have any. JK. So let's do this. So this is going to be a pretty steep roof. The thing about these tall buildings is you can't really see the roof unless you make them fairly steep. Or, I mean, if you make them like too flat, then you can't see them at all, right? So let's actually make this layer hay all around. And the less hay that we use, the less I have to farm. But now let's do it like this. I'm completely doing this off the top of my head, by the way. There's like no method to this. I know some people really struggle with roofs. I'm just making a fairly conic cone shape. And I'm going to mix in these other roof colors, which we use down here. And then something like this. Oops, hello. Like this. And then I don't have it with me or anything with me to do it. But I'm going to make one of these flags and then I'll be back. Isn't that pretty? That's a really cool sight, I think, actually. So, I can tell you all the changes that we did right from here. Wow, this is like clearly visible. I made a few little changes, and I'm in creative so I can fly around and show you. And got the light shaders on so that we can see what it looks like in that. Ooh, let's look from down here. Because this is the view that we're going to have of it most of the time. Be walking around here. Probably won't have a view of it from here once that roof's filled in. But then walk around here and bam, it's revealed. Definitely need a way to draw out this walkway a little bit, I think. It's just not quite there for me. It's like hard to see, especially from here. But then you walk over here. I want to get the sense of it that you get while walking up to it. And shaders are making me a little bit laggy. I think that's really cool that you walk up here and it kind of disappears. You know, you're around this corner and you can barely see it. You're like, ooh, it's up there. Gotta go see it. Close, but it's way up there. Then you're here. And there it is. I really like this build. I had some leaves onto it. I'm not really sure why there's leaves on it, but, you know, this side is pretty boring. And leaves make everything happier. I added these little roof parts right here above the peepholes. I had slabs here, and I switched them to walls, and I did a little bit more work here. I actually pulled the roof up higher because it wasn't as pointy as I was hoping that it would be, and then I added the flag. All in all, I think this is a really nice building. Now, this isn't anything like super original or anything. Ooh, I want to get rid of... Oh, that's gorgeous. I want to get rid of those furnaces and chests and whatnot and get a screenshot right here. I bet it would look really nice. Ooh, I need to turn up the render distance. Think about, I don't know, even when turning up the render distance, it seems sometimes, I don't know if it's just my game or Optifine or Minecraft, it has a hard time loading in really far away, even with the render distance way up. But this is a really pretty sight right here. I can't decide if I like it more from there or from like over here with the zoom function on, like that. No, down here. This makes you realize how high up it is, and you know the contrast of the sky is gorgeous. But I don't know. I got some thumbnail options this time. Anyways, yeah, they're looking to see if there's any dangers out there, and who knows, maybe they'll find one next episode. I guess you'll just have to come in and watch me next time to find out. So thank you for watching, everybody. See you next time. Bye.